So we're in Austin, Texas, heading towards the Alamo Drafthouse. And if you Google World's Best Theater, you'll find that the Alamo Drafthouse shows up consistently on every best of list. So I wanted to find out whether or not the Alamo Drafthouse can really live up to its reputation.
So there's other Alamos, but this one is very uniquely Austin. People just having fun rather than an establishment. It's more like a party.
I like the idea, and we try to do it as often as possible, and that's what we spend a lot of our time as a programming department doing, is how can we make going to the movies more than just plopping down in front of a screen. So we like to have personal touches. You know, people can connect to the movie theater, and it's more like a neighborhood movie theater. It's not a nameless, faceless, churn them out multiplex. I want people to know who I am.
My name is Cobra Commander. I'm the founder of the Alamo Drafthouse.
And that I'm in there watching movies with them, and I'm part of their community. And all of my programmers, all my staff kind of follow that same mentality.
I don't even think about it as showing movies. I think about it as big screen entertainment, and that's not because the screen is big, it's because you can have a crowd around you, and the things that you can do with a crowd change.
In case you've never been to a sing or quote along that are very important for you to know, it's actually in the name. You have to sing and quote along. We're gonna turn it up to 11 right now with This Is Spinal Tap, sing and quote along!
We do a couple of shows like this where we actually encourage people to talk, but not just to talk and say whatever they want, but to quote along with the movie or to sing along with the movie or the videos, and then you get that same sort of community sense. I'm an atheist, and it's kind of my church. It's like the church of pop culture, and so you need to stand up and sing the hymns, and every once in a while let your body shake and do the dance a lot.
We balance regular, you know, films in an unconventional screening environment with very unconventional films, and it seems to work out well. You know, we offer stuff for grandma to come see the new Transformers movie. Or they could stay 2 hours and watch like a really unbelievable, you know, exploitation movie from 1982 where like three people's heads blow up. And we just try to be the only theater that truly gives a shit about movies that have otherwise been forgotten. And that goes in the way we program and in the way we screen them and just the way that people even come out to watch them. Watching a great movie is a lot of fun, but what if you could eat like a really delicious sandwich while you watched a great movie? Like, that would be outrageous. People have like, you know, come to really appreciate that, and it almost feels like some great luxury.
The food service component of our theater has been controversial since the very beginning. It's challenging for us, and sometimes we lapse, and sometimes we do disturb people because we have to set plates down, but we try to do it incredibly delicately. Our waiters are sort of stealth trained, and there's no talking, it's just writing it down and putting it in a clip. And it's no more distracting, we feel, if we're doing it right, than people eating popcorn in a movie theater. And we always view ourselves a movie theater first and a restaurant second.
Please do tip your hardworking wait staff, and I'm only bringing this up so I can say the thing that always follows that, which is don't fucking talk during the movie. Ever since the Alamo, you know, kind of created its identity long before I was here, there's always been a really strict don't talk during the movie policy. And there's events, you know, that are different that aren't necessarily just watching a movie where people can have fun and they can kind of bust out. But when we're just screening a movie and we're really getting into it, no matter if it's like a low budget, you know, this action movie from the 80s or whatever, I mean, we treat all the movies with respect. So that brings with it this level of etiquette that we basically demand of the audience, which is, if you talk during the movie, we will kick you the fuck out of the theater, and that's it. And it takes like one babbling jackass to just ruin that for all the rest of the people in the theater that are watching it.
If somebody says that we're too hardcore, then they clearly don't get what our aesthetic is. I'm very aware that there's 200 people in an auditorium that paid good money to come and lose themselves in a movie. And if I'm talking, I'm destroying 200 people's lives in a very small way. The reason why I got into the movie business in the first place is that I was a movie fan. I love movies. That was my personal escape, and that's how I spent my free time. And I think that more movie theaters need to be run by people that actually are truly, madly, deeply in love with movies. And that needs to come first. And if you use that as your guiding principle, then I think there'd be a lot better exhibition all over the place.